Hello, welcome to the Great Outdoors RV. My name is Mait, and today we're going to talk about your freshwater system on your RV and how to use and maintain that. Your camper usually has two different ways to get water to it. One way is through the city water connection. In other words, what you do is you hook up to your city water connection at your campsite usually, and they have pressure building into your camper, and that's how you use your water system for camping. A second way is there is a portable water tank built into your camper, and you would use a water pump to basically pressurize the camper and bring the water with you in case you are in a place that doesn't have a water source where you're camping. Let me show you first how to use the city water connection. Let me show you how to hook up to the city water connection. One, you want to make sure you use a drinkable water or food grade hose. So not a rubber hose, but more of like a vinyl type hose that you can get in our parts store. A second thing that you will want is to get a water pressure reducer valve. The reason why this is rated between 40 and 50 PSI, you want to use this at the water source. That way your water flows more smoothly to your camper, and then this way you don't accidentally blow out the lines of your camper. So I'm gonna go ahead and hook this up to my water source, which you would hook this up at the campsite right here, and then you would hook up your hose right behind that. All right, so let's go over to the other end now. Step one, run some water through your hose so that way any bugs or any kind of debris that's in your hose is out before you put that into your camper. Okay, step two, turn your water source off for a second and make sure there's no debris inside blocking this screen here. And then you want to connect directly to your city water connection. And you're set to go. So at this point, go ahead and turn your water on at the water spigot, and then go ahead and turn on both your hot and cold water at your faucet. It will usually run for just a couple seconds with air, and you want to make it so that you have a constant flow of water before you turn that off. Just a reminder, don't turn on the water pump since we're using the pressure from the city to pressurize the camper water. If your camper keeps making noise beyond the first second or so after turning on your water pump, it means that you probably either have a valve opened or partially opened, or you might even have a leak in your camper somewhere. So you need to find that leak or find that valve and shut that off before you keep that water pump on and pushing water into your camper somewhere. One last thing to note, if you're not getting water to your sink right away, it's probably because it's filling up your water heater, which is usually around 6 or 10 gallons. So that might take a while to fill that up before you get water pressure all the way to your sink. Make sure you don't turn on your water heater until you have that water heater full of water from your water source, whether that is your freshwater tank or the city water connection. In order to fill up your water tank, you can do that either through the city water connection or the freshwater pump connection. Either way will fill this up, but only if you have the valves connected in the right way. This is your water heater. Let me show you how that works. There's three valves on here. One, two, three. This blue valve or line is going into your water tank. This valve either lets the water in or out of your water tank. It warms up the water inside here, and then it comes out this red tube right here, and then this is a second valve that lets water in or out of the water tank. I should say out is, or actually it stops it from going in here too. This is your bypass valve. This basically is when it's in winterized mode, the water will go into here through this middle part and then out. So you're gonna block this one and block this one while it's winterized, but and then open up this middle one. Now when you're about ready to go camping, you're gonna do just the opposite. You're gonna open up this guy, and close the middle one. The way you know if they're opened or closed is if it's perpendicular, it means it's closed. If it's parallel, it means it's open. So this one, since it's perpendicular, is closed. This one's open since it's parallel with the line, and then this one at the bottom is closed. So this is actually in a winterized mode currently. One more thing that you need to be aware of is certain campers have water filtration systems built into them. One of the things that you can do is they might have a little water strainer right here by the water pump. They can actually put it anywhere, but this is usually where you'll find it. You want this only hand tightened. You don't want to put this with a wrench because this is only plastic pieces. But this is a little strainer that will allow the water to be strained out before it goes into your camper. This valve right here is the valve that will stop the water from coming in as your from your freshwater sources, either your city or your freshwater, and allow you to hook into your antifreeze system for winterization purposes. One quick troubleshooting tip: if you have the water pump on in your camper and you notice water is coming out of your city water connection, that's because there's a check valve behind this guy here, and that's probably gone bad and you need to replace the check valve. The way that you would do that is you would unscrew this guy, put a new one on, and put it back together, and you'd be good to go again. This happens to be a docking station of a Sandpiper fifth wheel. This is a water filtration system that some campers have. This is a tool to be able to get the water canister off. And so what you would do is you'd put this around here, and then once you get it lined up, you can loosen this guy up. And then once that's loosened, this guy can come off. And then what you do is you would drop in this water filtration canister inside here and then put this back up. I do recommend you get this soaking wet for about 24 to 48 hours so that the water can go through here a lot easier. Otherwise, it's gonna struggle for that first little while. Another thing to note is that strainer is a good idea to have on here in addition to the water filtration system, because it can block some of the bigger particles before it gets to the water filtration system so that this guy doesn't get clogged up as easily. So this system looks a little bit different. The bypass valve is just a single valve that you turn on and off right here, as opposed to having to turn three valves. And the winterization valve is over here exposed instead of having to get behind like we were seeing on the last one. Now this does have the fresh water and the city water separated, but some of them have a valve like this that you switch from the fresh water over to the city water. Here's one more different setting where it has gravity one way and city the other way. So you would turn this to fill up either the city water connection or to fill up your fresh water tank. You would turn it this way and you'd hook up to the same outlet for both. Now, also check into, I'll explain water heaters and winterization in two separate videos, so check for those as well. I do recommend that you drain your water tanks and water lines after you go camping so you don't have stale water sitting in there. Let me show you how to do that. For your fresh water drain, this is for your water tank specifically. Sometimes there's a sticker that specifically says where that drain is, and that's right here underneath your water tank. And you would just open this guy up, and that will let the water come out of your fresh water tank. So these are your low point drains, which you'll want to empty out as well. One's for your hot water and one's for your cold water. Sometimes you only have one, but most of the time you'll see two different lines for that. So these are that for that part. And then in this particular coach, this is your low point drain, which is unmarked at this point because you can't see the fresh water tank, but that's what that one is for. The last thing you need to drain is your water heater. So you want to release the pressure of your water tank, and then you're probably going to need a socket, and they change in size, so I can't tell you what exact size this is going to be, but it's this guy right here. And this is your anode rod. You're going to pull this out, and this will shoot out if you forget to release that pressure right here. And you'll notice sometimes, guys, they'll put some tape around here to keep it as a tight fit. So here are a few things that you want to consider in our parts store to recap on all the things that we've talked about. One, water filtration system. This is an exterior one that you can buy if you don't have a water filtration system already built into the inline system. Two, a water tank filler. This makes it so that you can turn on and off the water at the end of the water hose, as well as get the air flowing through your water tank so that it can fill up twice as fast. Another thing, this is a premium pump strainer, but we also have normal ones, and this will strain the water so that it's either cleaner going through your faucet or cleaner going to your water filtration system. One more thing is you want a food grade drinking water hose. You can get this in either 50 foot or 25 foot. A couple more things that you want to consider. One is if you're going to leave some water in your system for a little while, consider getting a drinking water freshener. This will make your water taste normal for a little bit longer. If your water has already gone bad and it's stale inside your system and you need to clean out and deodorize your tanks, that's where this stuff comes in. This is called Spring Fresh, and you would pour some of this into your fresh water tank and then rinse it out a couple times and you'd be good to go again. So that wraps up fresh water in your RV. Let us know if you have any questions. We'd love to help you out. Thanks for watching our video. All the parts that you saw in our video are in our parts store. We have a full parts store and service department. Both our parts and service staff are very knowledgeable and can help you troubleshoot, make recommendations on either your travel trailer, fifth wheel, motorhome, pop-up, as well as your truck that you're towing it with, as far as anything from hitches to water, electrical, you name it. The Great Outdoors RV is located in Evans, Colorado. We're just the southeast side of Greeley, right on Highway 85, about an hour north of Denver. Our address is 3511 West Service Road, Evans, Colorado 80620. Our phone number is 970-339-1997, and our web address is www.thegreatoutdoorsrv.com.